In February of 2007, a grand multicultural celebration was held. Honoring noble individuals for their good governance and heroic humanitarian actions.
We do hope that one day there's not even a single frontier left between nations, but we are or will become brothers and sisters in the big global family.
Watch on to find out more.
Today's show will be presented in Tagalog with subtitles in Arabic, Aulacese or Vietnamese, Chinese, English, French, German, Indonesian, Japanese, Korean, Mongolian, Persian, Portuguese, Spanish, and Thai. Pagbati mga mahahalagang manunood, ako si Nilita mula sa siyudad ng Bislig na kilala sa mahiwagang Tinoyan Falls. Ang mga marangal na mamamayan ng Pilipinas ay hinahangaan at pinasasalamatan ang mga magagandang santo na katulad niyo. Noong buwan ng Pebrero, taong 2007, isang kamangha-manghang pagdiriwang ng Lunar New Year ang idinaos sa Hsihu, Taiwan, kilala rin bilang Formosa. Sa loob ng 3 araw na pagdiriwang, libo-libong mga miyembro ng asosasyon mula sa iba't ibang bansa ang nagtipon-tipon para mag-meditate, para sa spiritual na pag-angat at kapayapaan ng mundo kasama si Supreme Master Ching. Ito ay nagdulot ng isang kaaya-aya at napaka-pinagpalang atmosfera para sa nasabing mapalad na okasyon. Nagkaroon din ng buhay na mga pangbagong taong palabas na kumakatawan sa iba't ibang kultura ng mundo at maraming gabi ng vegan barbecue at masayang mga oras. Ang pinakamahalagang bahagi ng pagdiriwang ay ang masaksihan ang mga espesyal na bisitang pandangal ni Master mula sa Pilipinas habang kanilang tinatanggap ang Shining World Leadership Award, ang dating presidente ng Pilipinas, ang kanyang kamahalan Fidel Ramos, presidente ng Gusi Peace Prize Foundation, Ginoong Manuel Morato, at isang senador ng Pilipinas, ang kagalang-galang Hsihu Alvarez. Sa ngalan ng lahat ng mga refugee sa mundo, taos-pusong pinasasalamatan ni Master ang mga maawaing leader na nabanggit sa malugod na pagtanggap sa mga Aulacese na refugee, na nagpakita sa kanila ng pag-ibig at dignidad. Ngayon ay halina't makilahok sa masiglang pagdiriwang ng pagkakaloob ng gantimpala.
And now, the Shining World Leadership Award presentation. We will begin with the presentation of the flag of universal love.
Xin mời thượng kỳ, xin mời thượng nghị sĩ Alvarez.
and march us where we go.
Senator Alvarez, in recognition of your compassion, outstanding effort, and enlightening leadership in making a positive change for the world and all humanity, with compliments and gratitude for exemplary kindness, we present you with the Shining World Leadership Award. And here is your award letter. In recognition of your compassion, outstanding effort, and enlightened leadership in making a positive change for the world and all humanity, with compliments and gratitude for exemplary kindness, we present you with the Shining World Leadership Award. And here is your letter of award. Congratulations from the Supreme Master Qinghai International Association.
Supreme Master Qinghai, my good friend Manoling Murato, General Kunanan and Mrs. Kunanan, and of course my wife. It's like a fairy tale. I have not seen an event like this in my whole life, when so many cheering, lively, caring, loving people have spontaneously come together on top of a mountain to cheer the whole of humanity. And it's only tonight that I realize that that cheering is indeed well expressed. This human rights struggle reverberates to earlier days of my youth, when I myself was an exile because I fought the dictatorship in the Philippines and went underground for about 2 years until I had finally escaped to help lead the opposition, the democratic opposition in the United States. I filed for asylum, but there was no refugee asylum rule to protect me in the United States. We came from the so-called free world, which was the Philippines. And when you come from the free world, you're not supposed to be a refugee. I appealed to the United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees. I gave them the evidence, and they made the decision. They said that I am a bona fide refugee, that I am fighting for my political rights, and running away from the country because of political persecution. Side by side with the decision of the United Nations High Commissioner for Refugee, a leader of the American people, his name is Edward Kennedy, filed a bill in the U.S. Congress. It is a bill that opened up refugee applicants from many peoples of the world, including ours, including yours. That's why those who are running from political persecution are equally entitled to seek refuge in the United States. Finally, we won that struggle and restored freedom in the Philippines. And here we were with the golden opportunity of reaching out, extending our compassion and our love to our fellow freedom seekers, the Vietnamese, the Boat people. The hand of my government was tied up because there was an agreement among these countries that had hosted our brothers, the Vietnamese, to send them back and they will be received with understanding and humanity in their motherland. But they didn't want to go back. They wanted to seek freedom in other land. They had relatives in other land. They had relatives in Australia, relatives in the East Coast of the United States, in the West Coast of the United States. We had no refugee law. Our president sought for an enlightened judgment, and he found that if we had such a refugee law in the Philippine Congress, then we would have the fullness of freedom to keep them in the Philippines in spite of the fact that there's been some kind of an executive understanding with other ASEAN countries to send them home. And so when Master Ching Hai was moving around in the society in Manila, guided by Don Manuel Murato, they were caring hearts, they were compassionate human beings who wanted to keep and provided shelter, political shelter, to our brother Vietnamese refugees. The law was passed, and President Ramos assisted it all the way so that we were able to provide the haven of freedom that many of our brothers wanted to have in Manila. I am very grateful to the organizations all over the world. After that, we received delegations from San Francisco, California. We received delegations from Australia. We received delegations from Master Ching Hai, thanking us and telling us that we are one people in freedom. Thank you for this fine opportunity of having rediscovered ourselves, of being of service to our fellow human beings, and always to remind us and the rest of humanity that we cannot have oppression if we must have a happy humanity.
To my co-awardee, Senator Gerson Alvarez, who really worked a lot and helped a lot regarding the Vietnamese boat people. And I must acknowledge it that together with President Ramos, they really helped Supreme Master Ching Hai in those days that she was really having a lot of problem to help her people in Vietnam. When Supreme Master invited me to come to ashram to spend the new year in ashram, I didn't know what ashram was and what it is. So I came here to spend the new year, but I didn't know about this affair. She kept it a secret from me. So you can just imagine how touched I am that this thing is happening tonight. I wasn't expecting it at all. And thank you very much to all of you for being present tonight, because there is one lesson that we all have to learn, that we have to care for each other and love one another. So to all of you who kept this a secret from us, thank you. Thank you very much, especially to the Supreme Master.
Please.
Thank you.
Please trust us again. Even if we keep secret, but we are good people. Salamat. Salamat. Mabuhay. Mabuhay. That means thank you and best wishes in Philippines. And don't ask me any further, that's all I know. We thank you, these gentlemen here, for their unconditional kindness in helping the fellow human beings in time of need. Whenever any war breaks out, it could be any of us who will become a refugee. Imagine if it's us who are one of the boat people. Imagine if we have to go through all the suffering, all the hardship that they have to endure, being just a bystander of the war, being just an innocent citizen of the world. The thank you ceremony today serves also as a symbol of gratitude to all noble nations, including Taiwan, because Taiwan also housed the Vietnamese refugees in the beginning. Please, thank you, welcome. Taiwan, Thailand, Hong Kong, United States, Canada, all the European countries, etc., etc., we thank them all. And we also thank groups of people or individuals who are so noble, who open their heart and open their home to welcome, to care for the desperate victims of war. In the whole world, we thank them all wherever they are. We thank them on behalf of not only the Vietnamese refugees, but all the refugees in the world. We thank them all for their exceptional charity, generosity, noble, unconditional love. We thank them all from the very heart of our heart. We thank them for healing the wounds of the war and for returning the dignity to the people who deserve. May their touching and beautiful deeds brighten the dark corner of the world and brighten the dark corner of human history and brighten the dark corner of human's life. And we do hope one day this kind of corner no longer exists. Only bright, only peace, only love. We do hope that one day we only know about peace and that the world war will be forever forgotten in the dictionary of humankind. We do hope that one day there's not even a single frontier left between nations, but we are all will become brothers and sisters in the big global family. We thank them again. We thank you. We thank you. And we do wish that their beautiful, enlightened, compassionate action will shine through human history and through eternity. May peace, love, compassion prevail our hearts and this beautiful planet. We thank God Almighty. We thank Heaven above And we thank you all again and again. We love you.
我们还有一位很重要的贵宾，我们没有介绍到，这位是顾敏先生，联合国教科文组织团联合委员会常务委员。我们还有一位贵宾还没有介绍到，西湖乡农会古木贤理事长。
And now, performance groups from around the world have assembled here in Hsihu to celebrate the Lunar New Year and honor our wonderful guests. All the way from the sunny state of California, USA San Jose Center, we have a dance in three parts entitled Aulac New Year's Celebration. Part one is called the Gong Dance. Part two is called the Hip Hop Flower Dance. And part three is called the Happy Apple Cider Glass Dance. And part three, you are invited to join.
Người thương gia lại thân.
其实全部都是祝福大家，新年快乐啊，夫妻和和，生意发财，等等等等哈，连艺术家也多有那个灵感，可以多画画，多写歌颂、写诗，美化世界等等，全部都是美好的、吉祥的、快乐的、春天的歌颂，新年的。
Màn vũ mùa xuân ơi và ngày Tết quê em.
trong tim mọi người. Ngày Tết đến phố xá đông vui, người đi thăm đi biển đi chơi, người ta đi mua sắm Tết, người dâng hương đi lễ chùa. Ngày Tết nên ta chúc cho nhau một năm thêm sung túc an vui. Dù như năm người thương ra màu phát tàn, xuân xuân ơi xuân đã về kinh mình nào nè. Xuân xuân ơi xuân đã về, tiếng chúng ta thư chào đón mùa xuân. Xuân xuân ơi xuân đến rồi, cánh em bay về cho tim mình nào nức. Xuân xuân ơi xuân đến rồi, những đám mây vàng chào mừng xuân ra. Nghe âm vang bao câu chúc yên lành, đất nước ấm hoa yên ấm an vui. Bao em thơ khoe mấy tươi cười, chào một mùa xuân mới. Xuân xuân ơi xuân đã về, kính chúc một người với bao điều mong ước. Trong mừng xuân ta vẫy chào, kính chúc một nhà gặp nhiều an vui.
<音樂>也是一样祝福大家全部都好的就是最美好的不过他们用很不同的方法不同的音乐好漂亮祝大家是如是了如是这么美好 Thank you 感恩 Deb Yoy I'm proud of you
下一个节目是圣荷西小中心所表演的中东肚皮舞
These are all our association members 都是我们同秀呢贡献给各位欣赏
Thank you.
kamangha-manghang pagtatanghal ng ating mga miyembro ng asosasyon. Salamat sa labis na paggalang sa ating mga mararangal na bisita mula sa Pilipinas. Sa pamamagitan ng masayang pagbabahagi ng inyong mga pinagpalang talento, binabati naming muli ang ating mga Shining World Leadership Award Laureates. Naway, ang kanilang mga mapagmahal na halimbawa ay magbigay inspirasyon sa iba pang mga pinuno na buksan ang kanilang mga puso. Labis naming pinasasalamatan si Supreme Master Ching Hai sa pagkilala sa mga mapagkalinga at maawaing mga individual na ito sa pagkakataloob sa amin ng higit na lakas at pag-asa. Malayang mga manunood, ikinalulugod namin ang inyong panunood sa ang naliwanagang pamahalaan na lumilikha ng magandang kinabukasan. Ikalawang parte ng apat na bahagi. Mangyaring samahan niyo kami para sa ikatlong bahagi sa Martes, ika-apat ng Setyembre. Naway, ang kampana ng kalayaan ay tumataging ting para sa lahat sa ating maluwalhating planeta hanggang sa sunod na pagkakataon. Susunod, ang sama-samang katalinuhan ng mga hayo, ikalawang parte ng dalawang bahagi sa Supreme Master Television. Liberated viewers, we appreciate your being with us for Enlightened Government, Creating a Bright Future, Part 2 of 4. Be sure to catch Part 3 on Tuesday, September 4th. Up next is The Collective Intelligence of Animals, Part 2 of 2, on Supreme Master Television. May the bells of freedom ring for everybody on our glorious planet. See you next time. For more details, please visit suprememastertv.com/EE.
Nutrition is, in my view, essential for medical doctors to include in their practice, in the treatment of patients, because with nutrition, we are able to influence chronic diseases in a very positive way.
Nutrition is the most important thing that physicians should know because it determines so many different aspects of disease.
With each decrease in animal products in the eating pattern, you see a stepwise benefits in terms of heart disease, diabetes, cancer risk, obesity.
And what you can see here, you have on the left type 2 diabetes prevalence, and then you have types of diet. The vegans had the lowest at 2.9, and then you gradually go up and up. This data clearly shows diet is related to diabetes.
Rheumatoid arthritis, or psoriasis, or Crohn's disease, all chronic debilitating diseases. Even we have now Alzheimer's disease, cataract, old age blindness, the same experience, lower risk when you're on a plant-based diet, higher risk when you're on a Western diet.
According to the Academy of Nutrition and Dietetics, in su declaración del 2016, dietas basadas en plantas son seguras y sanas en todas las etapas de la vida, incluyendo embarazo, lactancia e infancia.
If you're eating that sort of diet, you're pretty much getting everything.
There's no need for meat, for iron, or dairy, for calcium.
All plant foods have protein, and almost all plant foods have all the essential amino acids.
I've never seen a protein deficient patient in 26 years of medical practice and 10 years of training before that. You get all the protein you need in a well-balanced, colorful, plant-based diet. My bodybuilding friends that go plant-based lift more, lift better, recover better, and compete better.
The risk that a man who consumes dairy products will develop prostate cancer is higher than the risk that a smoker will develop lung cancer.
动物性的饮食会造成14种常见癌症，比抽烟的影响更大。谷类消耗越多的国家或人们呢，他们 有一位大概55岁的一个男性，当时是因为糖尿病引发了我们眼睛的所谓的视网膜病变，造成我们眼睛里面就是很多很多的出血。经过他改变饮食过后，之后我最近这三四年追踪他的情况，他整个视网膜就整个就平息下来，本来那些反复出血的情况后来就没有再发生了，他整个身体的状况也都得到
Everything that has to do with inflammation improves dramatically with plant-based nutrition, and it ought to be a cornerstone of therapy of every one of those conditions.
That is the same diet that can help people lose weight, that can reverse heart disease, can also improve diabetes, can also be used to treat autoimmune disease.
The doctor can eventually, usually, bring down medication and in many cases stop.
We can not only stabilize diseases, we can even reverse it.
There's no medication that could come close to matching that.
We now have an abundance of irrefutable scientific data in the literature confirming that a whole food plant-based diet is ideal for optimal health, that eating plants can help your cells, your organs, your body stave off chronic disease, achieve and maintain your ideal body weight, enhance exercise performance, and thrive throughout the lifespan. I've seen this in the last 5 years since I implemented this protocol into my nutrition counseling practice.
When you go to the supermarket, just ignore the animal products. Go and fill up on the fresh fruit, the vegetables. That's all we're doing. We're sending our patients to the healthy part of the supermarket, and the results speak for themselves. People rid themselves of blood pressure tablets. They rid themselves of joint and muscle aches. They lose weight. They feel fantastic.
People feel improvement very quickly in a few days or maybe a week time. So satisfying for a doctor that you actually can see the patient get better.
The real question about whole food plant-based diet is, what doesn't it cure?
It's too good to be true, but it's true.
The benefits of going down that pathway from a health perspective are going to be nothing but 100% right.
More than any other aspect of your life, you can vote for a better world, vote for a cleaner world, vote for a kinder world, and enhance your own health by, you know, shifting your diet. It really is that simple.
Vas a vivir más y vas a vivir mejor.
A diet based in plant foods is the way to go.
It's the key. There's nothing better.
For the world, for the animals, those gorgeous souls that live with us on this planet.
Change your world and your interconnectivity with others by basing your diet on whole plant foods.
Goes on. Please visit suprememastertv.com/VE for further club list and info. Be veg now and join the club.